guys, hello, welcome back to Rooster Model Channel. How are you today? Do you feel fine? Yes, very good. My new lab, projects, after the unboxing of this amazing car. Now we need to prepare the body, and I will try to do my best to show you how I make the body, how I prepare the body. And it's a very awesome things, because today we need to cut the rear bumper and put the trans kit one and play with it. I will show you, and I hope that people understand what I'm doing, and it helps for some people. You know, in this channel I all the time want to help the other people to make it, so it's very important to see what I'm doing, which kind of tool I use. And it's awesome, by the way, what I'm making in the club. I'm just editing the video now of the part number two of the Lamborghini Urus. It's over there. We will walk on this side of the table. As I know, as I say, I have a lot of place to work, so I can work in the boat project, also for the club and also for you guys. But if you want to see the Lamborghini Urus that I am editing right now, so all you need to do is join to the club and enjoy with me. And I hope that people will get more information about this kit, and I think it's a wonderful kit. And that's it. Let's start, see the parts, see the tools, listen to me, walk very slowly. A long video, preparation of the body, it's all the time a long video for you guys. Sometime I make a short video, sometime long. But if you want to see all of this, just join us and subscribe to this channel, guys. Okay, so let's start. Yes, so guys, welcome back. I hope that everybody feel well. I think this part really help for the people that build and buy this amazing trans kit by OB Design. As I show on the unboxing, we have a wonderful things on this channel. And first of all, let's start with the tool that I will use. I use a cutting saw by Tamiya, many different of shape for this kind of job. As you can see, all by Tamiya. This is the knife that I will use, engraver by Tamiya 0.2. I will use also engraver 2mm with for some area that I will show you how to handle and work with this. I put it in blue one because it's different from the engraver. I will use a pen to mark the mold line, and after that we will sand it and remove. I will use sanding sponge 600 by Tamiya, and also a sanding paper 400 by Tamiya. I cut it to small pieces and I can work easily and sand and do what I want. So guys, as you can see over there, we have a different bumper. This is the new version of a Nissan GTR. So we need first of all cut it over there from all direction. Okay, we need to cut it until here, and also over there and over there, and come back until here, until this part will be separate. I will try to do it in slow motion and sometime in fast motion for the people that understand that it take a little bit time to engrave more of the time. But see my hand working and try to understand what I'm doing. First of all, what I do, it's I use engraver 0.2. remember, we have many different of size. Okay, I use a 0.2. It's a very good and not breaking. Okay, what I will do first of all is engrave all the area. Okay, all the area. You see the material going out? This is what I want you to do. Okay, don't put pressure, let the knife guide you. Do you see? Super easy for the people that want to remove some of the part and some of the area. This is how the right things and the right things to do
when you walk on a plastic, what you need to do is, after you engrave it a little bit here, engrave it here also, take your time. Don't stretch your model. After that, you will need to sand it. Take each time little bit material until it will remove, okay? Each time, little bit. You can turn it and come from this area. And what help you to get a more grip, it's your finger, yes? When you get inside to the groove, put your finger on your model and then get inside to the groove and take material out. Slowly, slowly. Take your time and enjoy. Okay? Each time, little bit over there, the smaller one. With let the blade all the time guide you. Okay? Do you see what I'm doing? If it's more helpful for you, you can use solid ground, hold it here and do the same process, guys. The same process, okay? And now I will show you something. You see this line over there? You have one line here and one line here, but it's very difficult to get with this blade, this area, the curve, okay? So what I will do, I will use this one. And it's very easy to get inside to the groove and take material also, okay? Because it's no have a shape like that. You see, it's like a knife. Okay, everybody understand? So when you have a shape, use this one. And it will be more helpful for you, for the people that all the time scratch the model when they engrave. I do it many times. In this area, it's not important. You can scratch it over there. We will not use this area, but don't scratch this area because after that you need to use a putty and fill it and sand it and again until you not see the scratch. So keep attention to this. Okay, I will continue to engrave everything and after that we will move to the saw and I will show you the second steps. Okay, guys? So enjoy the music, the face movement, and remember, this is going to be a little bit long, so I want to show you more things, not just the engraving, okay? So, enjoy! Yes, so after you engrave all the area, now it's the second step that you can make. You can use a saw blade and it's little bit deep enough to get inside and start little bit remove material, guys. I hope that you can see, I use this kind of saw and it's get inside first because the tip is little bit big, and now I start cut the plastic, guys. It's not a big task, it's not a big machine that some people can do. Just remember, if you use the right tool, if you use the right tool, I can play all the time with the tool to bring it to the place that I want. Do you see it's a little bit cutting? Most of the time you need to take the time. Most of the time you need to take the time in modeling, yes. It's good, good word, yes. So don't rush because remember after this model will finish, you want to see all the mold line perfectly, even if you replace bumper. So keep attention to this. and easily start cutting it. Yes, guys, slowly, slowly, until you be satisfied. This is in place. Try not destroy the modem. Okay, do you see it's a little bit moving? It's moving, so it means I'm in the right direction. I can use this one because they have a handle, get inside and see where it's not take material, and then I take it, push inside and take it out. And then it take material. Everybody see? It's out. If you need more, you can bend it a little bit and get inside with the saw and take more material, guys. Walk with the saw slowly, protect your hand, think before you do, because it can hurt you. Okay, one side is out. If I'm right or if I'm wrong, let's see. Yes, it's out. Everybody see? Now what you need to do is continue with the saw from one direction. Look, the saw, this saw, this kind of saw by Tamiya, it's a 0.15, yes? So it's get inside and bending. Okay, as you can see, I can bend it and it's go to the shape, and then you can walk easily. It's not take material straight, okay? And it's very good. For the people that buy this saw, it's very good. Some saw, it's a little bit hard and you can bend it and it's not get the shape of the groove. And it's very important, guys, very important. Because when you use the saw, it's take the material. Okay, each time use a different area. This one is straight, so it can easily get inside. You see what I'm doing? Now, be careful if it's a little bit big, take the smaller one, get to the groove, and see how to play with your cutting saw. Just make it slowly and enjoy. Don't worry if you get any scratch, and I will show you. Over there, I get a scratch. I don't know if you can see it on the camera. Camera, please focus. On this area, yes. Okay, if you can see smaller sketch, it's nothing. I will send it and nobody see it because this is on the body. If the sketch will be here, I don't care because I will not use this bumper. Okay, everybody understand? I remove the part again, get inside and little bit, take material each time, little bit. Each time, don't get rush, don't get too much attention. You can all the time use the engraver also to get deep more and more until you will see the body, and after that you can finish with the cutting saw. Okay, slowly, just do it slowly, guys. This is all the trick. The magic is work slowly when you do this kind of job. Okay, everybody see, yes? How is the music? In the end, I will remove it, and after that I will show you how I adjust the new bumper, okay? So stay tuned, I will remove it. Don't worry, it will be removed. You can bend it a little bit, hold it, and get inside the saw and take material. It's more easy and more nice, I think. Use my technique and work slowly and you will succeed. And if you get scratch, don't think, no, oh my God, I do a scratch. I know it's a trans kit, but all the time remember, you can sand and do many things, and I will show you, use a putty if you need, so some gaps, don't worry, okay? So let me finish it and we continue and we adjust this wonderful piece. So yes, after I remove this area and this area, same step. The last part is making this one. I use a saw blade. I get inside the groove and start slowly, slowly. Okay, guys, slowly, slowly get inside and see. Easy. Wow. We have it, guys. All the unnecessary material you can take. Sanding paper, little bit. Just first. For the first to see where you need to add some, if you need to add some material or something like that. Just remove, keep the shape of that and see how it's look like. First test it fit, guys. First test fit. Everybody see? This is perfect. Do you see? We can glue it over there and after that use a little bit putty and bring the right position. Also over there, what I need is remove a little bit this area, play with it, adjust it, guys. It's just a plastic, you can all the time easily work with knife, remove material from all direction and see where you need to sand and where you need to add some material. After you glue it, it's not a perfect, but we will make it perfect, okay guys? Second test fit. Look how much amazing it. This is my guideline, first of all, okay? Over there. So if this will be okay, this area, after that I will try to do my best to bring it a little bit here, a little bit here, and after that use a little bit putty, and all the gap will be perfect. Okay, guys? Super easy. Yes, let's take sanding paper, sanding stick, all the unnecessary material, I will remove it and make sure the fitment of this part will be super fitments. Wonderful, guys, look, no gaps, and it's amazing. Okay, everybody understand me? Little bit here, we need to, little bit sand here. We will take the sanding. Okay, make again test fit. Look, perfect. Everybody see? Just glue it in the right position and after that we will continue sanding and show you more things. But this is the first step on the preparation of the body. I know it's not a preparation of the body, it's some skills, but people, believe me, it's easy. And look, the different guys. Super awesome. So yes, guys, after I do the all the preparation, everything fit perfectly, now it's good time to use Bobsmith. It's a Instacure Plus. It's a little bit thick than the Bobsmith Gold, so I love to use it for this kind of job, and it's a little bit more stronger for make it. Okay, so what I will do, I will use on this area and also on this area. I will take a little bit and it will stay forever. Everybody see? And also on the other area over there, take a little bit more. After that I will make it from inside more glue. Okay, so the moment of yes, okay, verify the place, hold it from one area and hold it from other area. Wow, super awesome, guys. Now we will let it cure. Meantime I explain you what I'm doing. I also remove the skirts because on the hobby design they have a different skirts, so I just remove it. It's very simple and fit it. If you paint the car in the same color of the skirts, so you can glue it and paint together, it's all the time good. But in my situation, I need to paint it in black and the body will be in white. So before I glue it and after that mask, I prefer not to glue it now and just verify that everything look okay and fit perfectly. And that's it, guys. Okay, after it's a little bit cured, what I can do, let's take more Q-tip and get inside and put a little bit more over there inside, okay? It will make it a little bit stronger. When you do the polishing and you want to handle with the kit, and you don't want it to break, so you can all the time little bit add more glue inside, and it's a strong glue, so it will remove. Okay, until now everybody understand. Now, do you see over there we have a gap? It's a little bit big, and also over there it's a little bit big. What you can do is use some kind of a Insta. I will show you what I definitely will use. Epoxy, a putty, and I will push it from inside, and we can do it, and I will show you what I'm doing. And it's a very good technique to eliminate the gap. What you need to do is use both of them, and this is the first time that you see me working with this kind of material. What I do, I cut a small piece, I don't need too much, just a small piece like that, and small piece, it's a two separate parts. So all you need to do is take two pieces, okay? And I see people that play with it like that, it will stick to your finger. What you can do is use a little bit water, and I will show you. You need to remove all the plastics, the clear plastics, keep it here, and also on this one. Okay, and what you need to do now is mix it together, okay? Mix it with your hand, play with it until you will see the color that we get. But before it, a little bit water, because it will stick to your hand. So what I will do, I will put it in the water and I will play with it with water, okay? And I will show you what I'm doing. It's a very good technique for the people that want eliminate gaps. You know, in trans kit, not all the gaps fit perfectly, and I wish it will be fit perfectly, but I don't want to waste time, so I use a little bit putty. This is the color that we need to get, okay, guys? I will take a small piece, okay? Just a small piece, and push it. I will put it over there, I hope that you can see. Do you see? And push it all the way, okay, and cut the unnecessary material, because here we have the light, so I will remove it because I don't want. And if you can see, it's close the gap, okay? Push it, guys, push it, and push also this area, and you see the remain going out, okay? Very good. This is the one thing that I want to happen, okay? I want all the material going out from all the direction. I push it, okay? Do you see it, guys? Do you see the material? If I need a little bit more, I will use a little bit more, and again push it if you need, if it stick to your hand, a little bit water, and look, we have it, guys. This is how to close a gap. So now what we need to do is remove the unnecessary material. Everybody see? I hope that you can see it. Yes? And just use the knife to create smaller gap. The smaller gap, okay? All you need to do is create a little bit smaller gap inside. Look. Ta-dam! Do you see? After it will cure, it will. I will send it and verify that everything is okay, and I not. It's not interrupt me anymore. So, first of all, I close the gap, and it's very important. So let's do it from the other side. Little bit water, a small piece. Yes, this is how Yaniv close gaps. First time that you see it, but it's good. Okay, again from here you see the gap. You see inside we have a gap. I don't know if you can see. We will put it in the right place and we will push it. We need to push it, okay, because we want the putty get inside. And what you don't need, you see it's interrupt to the lighter over there. Cut it and remove it out, guys. Everybody see? Very good. In the same steps, guys. Okay, do you see how the putty get inside? Yes. Play with it, push it, until you'll be satisfied that all the gap gone. Yes, amazing. You can leave it and send it after that, but what I love to do is remove the unnecessary area because I don't want it in my model. You can remove it slowly. And once again, make the groove, okay? Because it's very important to leave a gap. Smaller gap. If it's a little bit bigger, you can push again and play with it until you'll be satisfied, guys. Everybody see? Now we have the perfect gap from both sides, and I love it, and I think this will be awesome. Over there, it's a normal, so I will not touch it, and it's look okay to me. So I hope that people love it. Remember, Tame epoxy, quick type. Don't send it today, wait after overnight, and it will be super awesome. So let's continue. I think this is what you need to do, because I put here the putty. I can send the mold line, but if you can see, the mold line is here. Okay, we have a small mold line over there, and also small mold line over there that we need to remove because it's from the factory. And we don't want to use it anymore. We don't need it. So why I put a pen? Because when I'm sanding, I know it's a flat. Okay. Over there we have a small mold line, and over there small mold line. But I will not remove it because in a Nissan GTR, this area and this area need to be in black, and this is my guideline. So after I paint the primer, I will show you that guideline that I can paint in white and see where I need to put masking tape, and once again use the masking tape and paint in black, okay? That I can mistake and forget to tell you about it. Okay, one more thing, don't forget, guys, don't forget. You see me engraving, but you need to engrave all the car, yes? All the mold line, all the gaps need to be engraving, okay? Engrave all the gap, make it four, maybe three or four times. It will be enough, especially when you paint the model in white, because the black pop up, and it's amazing. If you see everything in white, it's not nice. So after that, you will see when we will use the panel line, how much amazing is it. And I think it's awesome. Everybody see what I'm doing? I hope that people learn something new today. Yes, with the putty and how to fill it. Over there, I don't need to put nothing. I will just use primer, sand in, use primer again, and it will be perfectly After the glue will cure, I will dip the line over there and all over the place. But now the putty, let do the putty the work, and we will continue talk about it, and we see how it's going. Okay, guys. That's it. After that, what I love to do is sand all the body of the car and prepare it for primer, and after that, wash it with water and soap, and it's ready for primer. Look how much amazing this car is going to be. This is the hood, and this is the front bumper. Okay, just look how much amazing. How much? Wow, so aggressive. Look, guys, I love it so much. I want to say a big thank you for you, that for the people that see until here the video. I know it's a little bit long, but when you want to learn something, you need to invest the time, and this is what I'm doing, and I will continue make it because people love it, and thank you very much, guys. Also Model Channel, on the next part we will make the primer. I will show you, because I will explain you something. When you paint in white, especially when you paint in white, you see the difference between the color. This is a kind of vanilla and this is gray, okay? So if I will use a white primer, what will happen? This will be brighter and this will be a little darker because the undercoat. And it's very good lesson for the people to see what I'm doing. I can tell you what I'm doing, but I want you also to see it. What I doing is use a gray primer of all the car. Okay, I merge the white, the vanilla with the gray, and after that paint everything in white, and then I will show you the you not see the difference, because if you start right away to paint with a white, you will get different white in the base color and in the end result, and it will be not nice because the a hood and the front bumper and the skirts, and so the skirts will be in black, but the front bumper and the rear bumper. So it's very important for the people that want to paint in white, in a different color. I think in black definitely it's not important, but maybe in red or yellow, the brighter colors. So that's it. No more talking. Have a good day. Love you so much. See you next time, next Friday, with wonderful video, and I hope that you like it. Bye bye, guys.